Jurisdiction, Part 3, Family Courts. So we are still in letter C, that is the jurisdiction of various Philippine courts. Tapos na tayo sa jurisdiction ng MTC. In this video, what we are going to discuss is the jurisdiction of a special court, and that is your family courts. So we'll go now to Republic Act number 8369. Paano tayo napunta sa Republic Act number 8369? Because this is the act establishing family courts, granting the family courts exclusive original jurisdiction over child and family cases, thereby amending BP Bilang 129. The other name for your Republic Act number 8369 is the Family Courts Act of 1997. That is very clear according to Section 1. Section 5 of RA 8369 enumerates the cases that is under the jurisdiction of family courts. So we start first with cases that affect a child or children. So our mnemonic is GCash, pera, GCash. So G stands for guardianship, C is for custody of children, other C is the commitment of children. Take note that that commitment could either be voluntary commitment or involuntary commitment. Your A is for the adoption of a child and also include the revocation of adoption. S stands for the petition for support or the acknowledgement of a child. Another S is for the suspension, termination, or restoration of parental authority. Another S is if you want to declare the status of a child, whether that child is abandoned, dependent, or neglected. And last is letter H, the famous petition for habeas corpus in relation to the custody of the minor. Take note ha, dito sa habeas corpus, in the case of Thornton versus Thornton, ang naging issue sa kaso na to is whether or not the Court of Appeals has jurisdiction to issue writ of habeas corpus in cases involving custody of minors. Bakit yan ang naging issue, the sole issue only in that case? Because if you're going to read Section 5, Section 5 of RA number 8369 is very clear that family courts shall have exclusive original jurisdiction over petitions for habeas corpus. And what did we say again? What is the definition of exclusive? That is to the exclusion of all other courts. But ano ang sabi ng Supreme Court? The provisions of RA number 8369, it reveal no manifest intent to revoke the jurisdiction of the CA as well as the jurisdiction of the Supreme Court to issue writs of habeas corpus relating to the custody of minors. Kaya ang rule is family courts together with the Court of Appeals and the Supreme Court, they have concurrent jurisdiction in petitions for habeas corpus where the custody of minors is at issue. So take note of that ha, wag kalimutan. So aside from GCash, what else? I call this special laws because for your cases against minor that is cognizable under the Dangerous Drugs Act, the family courts have jurisdiction. Also, for the violations of RA 7610 or the Special Protection of Children Against Child Abuse, Exploitation, and Discrimination Act, still the jurisdiction is under the family courts. For your cases of VAWSI, domestic violence against women and children, and other cases cognizable under PD number 603. Ano ba yung PD number 603? That is the Child and Youth Welfare Code. Other cases also that is cognizable under Executive Order number 56, series of 1986. Ano naman yan? That is authorizing the DSWD to take protective custody of child prostitutes and sexually exploited children and other cases of related laws. 2012 bar exam question MCQ, Cesar, age 16, and also a habitual offender, he was caught in possession of 0.001 grams of marijuana. He was charged for violation of Section 16 of RA 9165, that is the Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Law. The court which has jurisdiction is letter A, MTC, the RTC, Special Drugs Court, or letter D, the Family Court. Of course, the answer is letter D, the Family Court. Kakasabi pa lang natin, for cases against minor that is cognizable under Dangerous Drugs Act, the Family Court has exclusive original jurisdiction. 2015 bar exam question, Juliet here, she filed a case against her husband. The case was filed in the Family Court because it is a petition for the issuance of a temporary protection order. Of course, si husband inopposed niya, and among the issues raised in his opposition is the constitutionality of the Vaucy Law, the RA 9262. The judge, the Family Court judge, declined to rule on the constitutionality of the Vaucy Law because according to the judge, family courts are without jurisdiction to pass upon constitutional issues, it being a special court of limited jurisdiction. So question, do you agree, is the Family Court judge correct when he declined to resolve the constitutionality of RA number 9262? Answer is no, the family judge is not correct. This is the case of Garcia versus Drilon. Ano ang sabi ng Supreme Court in that case? Ang sabi niya, family courts, even though you are designated as a special court of the same level as the RTC, still remember that you are still a court of general original jurisdiction. You still possessed of that authority. Therefore, you can hear, you can decide, or you can pass upon all cases, all kinds of cases, whether that is civil, criminal, special proceedings, land registration, guardianship, naturalization, admiralty, or insolvency. Kaya ikaw, family courts, you still have that authority and jurisdiction to consider the constitutionality of a statute. So aside from cases affecting a child or children, or cases wherein special laws are involved, there are also family cases which fall under the jurisdiction of the family court. So ano yung mga family cases? These are your annulment of marriage, declaration of nullity of marriage, the status and property relations if you are a husband and wife, and if you are not a husband and wife or living together under different status and agreement, then you have the status and property relations. Also, the dissolution of conjugal partnership of gains, and then you have the petitions for constitution of family home. You have also the summary judicial proceedings brought under the provisions of family code. An example of this is your Article 41 of the family code, yung you want to declare presumptive death, declaration of presumptive death. And then take note also that family courts have jurisdiction over criminal cases as long as in that criminal case one or more accused is below 18 but not less than 9 years old. Kung wala namang akusado na involved na minor, pwede rin si family courts in that criminal case as long as one or more victims was a minor at the time of the commission of the offense. Take note also of Republic Act number 9775, otherwise known as the Anti-Child Pornography Act of 2009. Bakit napasama to sa ating discussion? Because if you're going to read Section 8, sino ang may jurisdiction over cases for violation of the Anti-Child Pornography Act? Answer is family court. Jurisdiction over cases for violation of this act shall be vested in the family court, which has territorial jurisdiction over the place where the offense or any of its essential elements was committed. Balikan ulit natin si RA 8369. You read Section 7 because the family courts can issue or it can order special provisional remedies. It can issue a restraining order. It can order a temporary custody of children. It can also order support pendente late. Section 12 of RA 8369 is also very, very important. That is the privacy and confidentiality of proceedings in the family court. So take note that the records of the case shall be dealt with at most confidentiality and the identity of the parties shall not be divulged. 2011 bar exam question, how should the records of child and family cases in the family courts or regional trial court designated by the Supreme Court to handle family court cases be treated and dealt with? Kakasabi pa lang natin, records of the case shall be dealt with at most confidentiality. Another bar question, under what conditions may the identity of parties in child and family cases be divulged? Section 12, again, is very clear. Dalawa ang conditions in order for the identity of parties to be divulged. First is necessary. And number two, take note ha, the word used is and at hindi or. So, aside from necessary, kailangan may authority of the judge. So, dalawa ang conditions. So you read also Section 14, how do you appeal the decision rendered by the family court? Just file a notice of appeal. So this is a case of an ordinary appeal.